Hello, amazing human beings. It is Friday, fun Friday. I am so excited to be here with you. It is Friday. We've made it to the weekend. So we've been talking about gratitude and thankfulness and kindness and self-talk and how important all of that is. I've been thinking about this really awesome book. It's called Those Shoes. And I love reading this book, especially with Ethan, because it's just a sweet book and I can't wait to get to it. So we're going to have our little dance party. We're going to read Those Shoes, and then we're going to go straight into the 31 days of Christmas. We're going to find out what act of kindness you can do for today. Let me share my screen. And let's have a little bit of a dance party. Let's get that adrenaline going. Awesome. I'm going to stop that there and I'm going to go straight into the story because then it'll be a very long session. But the book is called Those Shoes. It's a very sweet book. I have it here. I'm going to show it to you on the screen so that you can actually see the words. So it's Those Shoes. The author is Maribeth Bolts and it's illustrated by Noah Z. Jones. I have dreams about those shoes, black high tops, two white stripes. Grandma, I want them. There's no room for want around here, just need, Grandma says, and what you need are new boots for winter. Brandon T comes to school in those shoes. He says he's the fastest runner now, not me. I was always the fastest before those shoes came along. Nate comes to school in those shoes. Antonio and I count how many times Nate goes to the bathroom. 7 times in one day, just so he can walk up and down the hall real slow. Next, Alan, Jacoby, and Terrence each get a pair. He really wants those shoes, right? Look, Sloppy Joe's for a dollar. Then one day in the middle of kickball, one of my shoes comes apart. Looks like you could use a new pair, Jeremy. Mr. Alfrey, the guidance counselor, says. He brings out a box of shoes and other stuff he has for kids who need things. He helps me find the only shoes that are my size, Velcro, like the ones my little cousin Marshall wears. They have animal on them from a cartoon I don't think any kid ever watched. Then I come back to the classroom. Alan Jacoby takes one look at my Mr. Alfrey shoes and laughs. And so do Terrence, Brandon T, and everyone else. The only kid not laughing is Antonio Parker. At home, Grandma says, how kind of Mr. Alfrey. I nod and turn my back. I'm not going to cry about any dumb shoes. But when I'm writing my spelling words later, every word looks like the word shoes, and my grip is so tight on my pencil, I think it might bust. I wasn't kind of them to laugh at him. Little things like that, right? I'm gonna be kind. On Saturday, Grandma says, let's check out those shoes you're wanting so much. I got a little bit of money set aside. Might be enough, you never know. At the shoe store, Grandma turns those shoes over so she can check the price. When she sees it, she sits down heavy. Maybe they wrote it down wrong, I say. Grandma shakes her head. Then I remember the thrift shops. What if there's a rich kid who outgrew his and got two pairs for Christmas and had to give one of them away? We ride the bus to the first thrift shop. Black cowboy boots, pink slippers, sandals, high heels, every kind of shoe except the ones I want. We ride the bus to the second thrift shop. Not a pair of those shoes in sight. Around the corner is the third thrift shop. I see something in the window. Let's see. Black shoes with white stripes, high tops, perfect shape, $2.50. Those shoes. My heart is pounding hard to take off my shoes and hitch up my baggy socks. How exciting, Grandma says. What size are they? I shove my foot into the first shoe, curling my toes to get my heel in. I don't know, but I think they fit. Grandma kneels on the floor and feels for my toes at the end of the shoe. Oh, Grandma, oh, Jeremy, she says, I can't spend good money on shoes that don't fit. I put the other shoe on and try to walk around. They're okay, I say, holding my breath and praying that my toes will fall off right then and there, but my toes don't fall off. I buy them anyway with my own money, and I squeeze them on and limp to the bus stop. At home a few days later, Grandma puts a new pair of snow boots in the closet and doesn't say a word about my two big feet shuffling around in my two small shoes. Sometimes shoes stretch, I say. Grandma gives me a hug. Look at all the band-aids on his toes. I check every day, but those shoes don't stretch. I have to wear Mr. Alfrey's to school instead. One day during math, I glance at Antonio's shoes. One of them is taped up and his feet look smaller than mine. After school, I head to the park to think. Antonio is there, the only kid who didn't laugh at my Mr. Alfrey shoes. We shoot baskets at a loose piece of tape in Antonio's shoe smacks the concrete every time he jumps. I think I'm not going to do it. We leap off the swings. I'm not going to do it. We race from one end to the playground to the other. I'm not going to do it, I say. Do what? Antonio says, breathing hard. Look at Antonio's tape on his shoes. Grandma calls me for supper and invites Antonio over too. After supper, he spies my shoes. How come you don't wear them? Antonio asks. I shrug. My hands are sweaty. I can feel him wishing those shoes were his. That night, I am awake for a long time thinking about Antonio. When morning comes, I try on my shoes one last time. Before I can change my mind, my shoes are in my coat. Snow is beginning to fall as I run across the street to Antonio's apartment. I put the shoes in front of his door, push the doorbell, and run. You see him running? You see the shoes right here? At school, Antonio is smiling big in his brand new shoes. I feel happy when I look at his face and mad when I look at Mr. Alfrey's shoes. But later, when it's time for recess, something happens. Everywhere, there is snow. Leave your shoes in the hall and change in your boots, the teacher announces. Leave your shoes in the hall. It's then I remember what I have in my backpack, new boots, new black boots that no kid has ever worn before. Standing in line to go to recess, Antonio leans forward and says, thanks. I smile and give him a nudge. That was very kind of him. Let's race. This is a very sweet book about like just kindness, an act of kindness, right? As much as he wanted those shoes and found them at the thrift shop, they didn't fit him, but he saw that there was another classmate in need, another classmate that was kind to him, and he passed those shoes along to him. So that was a very sweet gesture, and I want you to always just have kindness in your heart. You know what I almost forgot to do? I almost forgot to share again. Where is it? Hold on, let me stop sharing. I almost forgot to share. I think it's this one. Give me a second. 31 Days of Kindness Challenge. So let's talk about Friday's Kindness Challenge. Let me erase this. Compliment everyone at your house. So compliment means to say something kind or nice to everyone at your house. That is your kindness challenge for Friday. So I hope you have a super amazing day. Have a great weekend and just enjoy today. Have an awesome day. Make it a great day.